minutes away from game time, the excitement begins to boil at Notre Dame Stadium.
So I have the same energy. My blood is the same as everyone else. We all have blue and gold blood. And I'm just real fired up.
The preparation is complete.
I think everybody's having butterflies. You know, you get that this time of the year.
The coaches and players are ready.
I've got tremendous respect for our players, tremendous respect for the job they did in the offseason. And I think we're a better football team because of it.
It's Notre Dame football, and we are just 90 minutes to 99. This is a Newscenter 16 special presentation. You are looking at a live picture over the Notre Dame campus. The fans are coming into the stadium for the earliest season opener ever.
And speaking of enthusiastic, energetic, enthusiastic, fun, and full of Notre Dame spirit, the Fighting Irish Leprechaun helps to boost the spirit.
And the man chosen to lead the pack is the epitome of those things and more. Newscenter 16's Claudine Wong takes you along for a glimpse at a day in the life of the Notre Dame Leprechaun, a young man who is already making history.
It feels sort of like a Superman costume. It's like I have the jacket and the hat on. It's usually the last two things to go on. Once those two are on, it's I'm a leprechaun.
Not everybody gets to come through there.
A little more than 24 hours before game time, Mike Brown is suited up and ready.
You know, I'm fired up, but have to work on coming down a little bit, make sure people hear what I have to say.
He's headed for the Notre Dame luncheon.
There are any Irish fans in this building? Let me hear you say, let's go Irish! Let's go Irish!
I know you have to go back, get ready for practice in the meeting.
After a little Q&A with head coach Bob Davey, he's off. Right.
My name is Michael.
Snapping pictures with the fans. He knows he's a pioneer. Brown is the first black leprechaun in Notre Dame history.
All right, you got the questions in my mind sometimes. Like, wow, the first black leprechaun. You got the first black astronaut. But I think every leprechaun is really making history because they're the first ones, I guess, from either from their family or from their hometown.
Great job out there today.
Thank you.
At this moment, the only thing on his mind is the pep rally as he works over details with basketball coach Matt Doherty.
Thinking about trying to make him do the wave or something.
Minutes later, he's off again.
The sideburns come down here and try to get it like a V cut.
Getting that famous beard tidied up.
You look good, you feel good, you know.
What's up, dude? What's the word, y'all?
Go Irish, go! Go Irish, go Irish, go! Go Irish, go!
It's a little practice before checking messages.
And last but not least,
getting a little rest. The pep rally is just hours away.
We're joined by Michael Brown.
There are quick TV appearances.
I hear a rumbling. I hear a roar.
Warm up.
They're waiting, dude. They're waiting. I can't believe this.
And then it's time.
Notre Dame and mother, pray for us. One, two, three.
Go, Irish!
We're not in Kansas anymore! Make some noise! What a football team, Matt!
The day is a success.
All right, coach.
The game ever closer.
The first meal after the first pep rally. Before the first game.
The night winds down with friends. A call to mom.
How's everything for tomorrow?
Then the leprechaun calls it a night. Left only to wonder, what will game day be like?
Go Irish, be Kansas.
Michael Brown was up bright and early this morning, and you can bet our cameras were right there with him as we followed through him through the game day ritual. So what was his day like? Well, we'll tell you a little later, coming up in later on in the special. Don and Jeff.
Thank you, Claudine. You know, Michael Brown is such an endearing young man, Jeff. I talked to him yesterday back home in Milwaukee. All summer long, they said his friends were teasing him, calling him Lucky Charm, and asking him where his pot of gold was, but he took it in stride. He laughed it off.
There is no substitute for enthusiasm and passion, and that young man has got it He is great. He's going to have a great season.
We're looking forward to it. For some, it's a dream come true to sit in the house Rockne built to watch the Fighting Irish play. And we're just 12 minutes, as you can see from our countdown clock, 12 minutes until kickoff. An enthusiastic fan, and speaking of enthusiasm, his charge is to increase the spirit level of the team and the fans. And after your initial meeting with Michael Brown, you'll know that it's certainly true.
Newscenter 16's Claudine Juan spent some time with Notre Dame's newest mascot. She learned his enthusiasm is certainly contagious.
If there are any Irish fans in this building, let me hear you say, let's go Irish!
Mike Brown has spent the last 24 hours tidying up.
Look good, you feel good.
Go Irish, go, go Irish.
Warming up.
What a football team, man!
He has been eating up and resting up.
See you tomorrow. Go Irish, beat Kansas.
All in preparation for this day.
Woke up to the fight song, playing in the halls, the people were going nuts already.
How's it going? You ready for the game? You excited?
Yeah.
On game day morning, he gets a quick bite.
That should be enough, I hope.
You need to eat lots of sugar to keep up all that energy you have. It's incredible.
Lucky charms for game day. Oh, yeah. Lucky charms. The magically delicious.
There is just enough time to fulfill a cafeteria dare.
Listen up, everybody! We're fired up to beat Kansas today! If you're fired up, let me hear you say, let's go Irish!
Before suiting up, taking a few pictures.
I ain't do that.
Irish! Go Irish, go!
And taking on a few rallies.
Irish! All right,
there is very little time left. Time to get a few more pictures.
Yeah, we have a good pitch.
Time to see a few more fans.
Notre Dame, woo!
And then, it's time for kickoff.
Woo!
No, it's going to be a long day. It's going to be a long, even longer one for Kansas.
All right.
And I'm joined now live with Leprechaun Mike Brown. This is your first time on the field during a game. How do you feel?
All fired up, baby. I got the most fired up fans in the nation right here. We got all the student body around us. We have the best Notre Dame fans in America, baby. Here we are. We're really fired up. I can't even express it. It feels as though we played a quarter already. But you know what? Kansas has already been beaten, baby. They're going down today. We already been beat. They heard the band in the locker room back there. They can hear the songs reading. Go, Irish. It's just reading all in their ears.
Okay, now I haven't seen you in the last 24 hours do a single push-up. I want to see you do a push-up just like you would do when they score. Go
We're
ahead.
Doing 70. We're doing 70 tonight. We're doing 70 today.
All right, let me see you.
Couple.
Well, he's got that down. That's awesome. He says he's going to do 70 of those. Let's hope so.
That'd be nice.
A special guy.
Coming up, Dick Enberg and Pat Hayden join us for Notre Dame and Kansas. Thank you for watching. Good afternoon.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And all that benefits only shooting stars. Somebody once asked, could I spare some change? Well, guess I need to get myself away from this place. I said, yeah, what a concept. Could use a little fuel myself, and we could all use a little change. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Back to the rules that I'll hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And go.